Well, speaking of the American people, I'm thrilled that we were able to join forces with a wonderful representative of them. Her name is Becky Gerritsen. Many of you are familiar with her from her efforts to represent them in a more official capacity, but she does a wonderful job now as the executive director of the late and much lamented Phyllis Schlafly's terrific Eagle Forum chapter here in Alabama. She is going to say a few words about what the American people, the regular people of this country, expect us to be doing about this threat, and introduce one of her colleagues, a retired U.S. Coast Guard commander, Teresa Hubbard, to speak as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Eagle Forum of Alabama is honored to be standing with leaders in the defense community and from the Secure the Grid Coalition who are here today, some of whom have been speakers at our events nationally and in regional conferences in the past. Educating citizens on the vulnerabilities to our critical infrastructure is one of Eagle Forum's priorities. We agree that the scientific data that the threats to our country's energy sector are real and that the grid is in need of hardening. It is the constitutional duty of our government to provide for our common defense, and we applaud President Trump's executive order on coordinating national resilience to electromagnetic pulses. We look forward to working with Alabama's energy sector and government agencies to ensure that our state has a secure grid. I would like to introduce Teresa Hubbard. She's retired U.S. Coast Guard commander, and she is Eagle Forum's counterterrorism chairman. She's going to say a few words.
I have to write down everything because if I don't, I get very long-winded. I'm going to quote Dr. Peter Vincent Pry, who you've heard earlier today. He starts out, I ask the question, what exactly is an EMP type event and why should we be concerned? Dr. Peter Pry explains it this way. He says, this new warfare uses cyber viruses, hacking, physical attacks, non-nuclear EMP weapons, and a nuclear EMP attack against electrical grids and critical infrastructures. It renders modern armies, navies, and air forces obsolete. It paves the way for asymmetric warfare by small nations and terrorist groups. Additionally, there is a naturally occurring phenomenon called geomagnetic disturbance from extreme solar weather or solar superstorms. An EMP type event or a solar superstorm has the capability to instantly destroy America's critical infrastructure, causing a complete blackout of its electrical grid and instantaneously obliterate any equipment that has a microchip in it. These occurrences will cause little physical harm to the population except for those that may have a medical implant, but either event will take the 2019 American population instantly back to 1849 living. The electricity goes out with no notice, the internet is down, your car won't start, your cell phone doesn't work, the TV goes off, the radio is out, you turn your emergency weather radio on for information and nothing is on the air. There's no way to reach out to any state, local, or federal agency to figure out what is going on. Are we ready? The resounding answer is no. The people are not ready, the government is not ready, and those in charge of our critical infrastructure are not ready. Our elected officials, as well as those in charge of our electrical grids, are aware of the dangers of an EMP type event and have done little to protect our homeland. It only takes missing five meals before an individual begins to panic and do things they would not otherwise do because of hunger. Think of the collapse of society all across our land when no resources are coming into a community. No safe drinking water, no medical supplies, no gasoline, no food, no electricity, therefore no heat or air conditioning. We cannot feasibly stop a solar superstorm per se, and we will always have enemies that will want to do us harm. But we can harden and protect our infrastructure against such potentially catastrophic events. Every business, utility company, military organization, and government agency are tied to the civilian electrical grid and its internet in some way. We as the electorate must insist that our elected officials, as well as those in government who have the oversight and responsibility to ensure the protection of our electrical grid and critical infrastructure, take this issue seriously and do all they can do to protect the American homeland and its people. Thank you.